الرحمن الرحيم. This is one of the Arab board common questions, also the Saudi board and the Egyptian board. The single greatest risk factor for necrotizing enterocolitis colitis. A. Prematurity. B. Beta ductus arteriosus. Endomycetin therapy. Polycythemia. Hypoxemic insult. Which one is the single greatest risk factor for necrotizing enterocolitis? As you know, the risk factor is 3B. Prematurity, which is the most important. Then the premature formula, formula feeds. And 3B of ischemic gut. 3B of ischemic gut, like prenatal asphyxia and BDA and polycythemia. And polycythemia, all is risk factor for necrotizing colitis, but the most important single risk factor, it will be the prematurity. The prematurity. So put in your mind, the single greatest risk factor for necrotizing enterocolitis is prematurity. Prematurity, then others. Then others. If you see here, this is the X-ray, classic for necrotizing enterocolitis, call it pneumatosis intestinalis. Also, the X-ray, there is 3B finding for necrotizing enterocolitis: pneumatosis intestinalis and portal gas and pneumoperitoneum or perforation. Or perforation, pneumatosis intestinalis, portal gases, and pneumoperitoneum or perforation. Sometimes we said peritonitis. So this is the intramural gas. You see, this is the intramural gases. This is by blue line. This is arrow. This is intramural gases. So the single risk factor, prematurity. Single risk factor is the prematurity. Other risk factor, others, but other risk factors, call it premature formula, due to advancing of the feed or non-human milk feeds, and also the 3B of intestinal ischemia. It's leading to intestinal ischemia. This is prenatal asphyxia, BDA, and polycythemia. And polycythemia. Also, the other risk factor, the mother is taking cocaine, it will be 2.5 times increase the risk, and also the umbilical catheter. This is risk factor for the necrotizing enterocolitis. How to assess this patient? Clinically, laboratory, and radiological evaluation. Clinically and laboratory, and also radiological evaluation. This is the clinical assessment. It will be abdominal distension, greenish aspirate, the patient is not passing stool, feeding intolerance, and all this is the clinical pictures of necrotizing enterocolitis in the premature babies. It's specific. This is called the most common GI medical emergency in unit. This is common GI medical emergency in unit. What is about the laboratory? It will be HAT. This is H is standing for hyponatremia, and A stand for acidosis, metabolic acidosis, and T stand for thrombocytopenia. Thrombocytopenia. So you have to request for general profile or electrolytes and the blood gas and CBC or FBC to looking for the thrombocytopenia, metabolic acidosis, and hyponatremia. Hyponatremia. Radiological assessment, it will be actually according to baby stages. Initially, into the stage one, it will be actually non-specific. A or B, non-specific. Then B, it will be PA, it will be pneumatosis intestinalis. Pneumatosis intestinalis. This is intramural gases. Then in the stage 2P, it will be portal gases. Portal gases, it will be in the liver. I'm the sugar kid. This is like a tree. Then it will end in the stage 3A and P. It will be pneumatosis, it will be pneumoperitoneum or perforation, pneumoperitoneum and perforation. But in your mind, the most important greater risk factor or necrotizing enterocolitis, it will be prematurity. And what is the risk factor? 3B, the prematurity, and also premature formula. And the third one, it will be the 3B of ischemic gut, the prenatal asphyxia, BDA, and polycythemia. And the finding in the X-ray, it will be 3B, pneumatosis intestinalis, portal gases, and peritonitis or pneumoperitoneum, or free air. ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا، سلام عليكم.